Well, Victoria, what are you serving weather-wise?
Well, for dinner, we have more showers in the forecast, unfortunately. But for breakfast, we have more sunshine, so okay. A little bit of everything.
You're going with this one, man.
Okay, good. Over the next few hours. So, unfortunately, that rain is starting to ramp up as we go throughout the evening. Let's take a look right now at downtown Savannah. We do have fog in the forecast as well, mixing with that rain, making visibility on the low side. You can't even see the Talmadge Bridge for the moment over downtown, 62 degrees. We do have rain back in the forecast for tonight. We got a few hours of dry time for today, but that's going to change going into the evening hours. Let's take a look at visibilities right now, mainly sticking to I-16. We do have patchy, dense fog right now in Savannah that has lessened just a little bit. You can see about 3 miles ahead of you, and Hinesville about 2 miles. So if you are traveling on I-16, you definitely need to take it a little slow on the roads for tonight. Storm tracker radar right now showing you we are dry for the most part. We're going to stay dry for a little bit more. A few showers firing off of the coastal waters for the moment, but we do have spotty showers and heavy rainfall in the forecast going into tonight. Once again, it will be similar to Sunday night. So this is by 8 p.m. tonight. We still have showers mainly sticking towards the low country north of I-16, but that'll ramp up as we go into about 11 p.m. tonight. The outer bands of the low pressure system will swing its way into the southeast. We're seeing patches of red, orange, yellow that's signifying heavier rainfall back in the forecast. Unfortunately, there could be flooding on the roads once again as we go throughout the evening. But heading into Tuesday morning, we start to see less rain, more sunshine. So by 6 a.m., a little bit of rain still sticking to the area. There is about a 40% chance of rain through the morning hours. But as we head into about 1 p.m. on your Christmas Eve, we finally see some sunshine. We do have mostly sunny skies in the forecast for tomorrow. And as that rain moves out through the morning hours, we are staying dry through the rest of the day. So Santa should have an easy commute to your house for Christmas Eve. We are in a flash flood watch though until 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. As that heavy rainfall makes its way into the area, there could be flooding and it can occur quickly. So if you are heading out the door tonight, getting some last minute shopping done, you need to keep an eye on the road. So this is what you can expect through your Christmas Eve. Rain continues tonight. It will be heavy at times. We are expecting about 2 inches more of rain through the evening hours into your Tuesday morning. A few showers lingering through your Christmas Eve morning, and then we'll dry out through the next few hours. But rain totals have gone up a little bit too. Again, we are expecting about 2 more inches of rain. Skidaway has over 5 inches of rain. The Hunter Army Airfield in Savannah, almost 4.5 inches. And Statesboro, almost 2.5. Rain totals have been very widespread across the area. Townsend has almost 6 inches of rain. Buford at 4. And Reidsville, only about 1.5 inches of rain. So that rain started on Sunday night, and it has continued throughout the day. We had dry hours today, but again, rain chances are ramping up as we go throughout the evening. So Tuesday, once again, 40% chance of rain. That's mainly through the morning hours. We should be good to go through the rest of the day for your Christmas Eve. 69 degrees. We're dropping to the 40s for that low temperature. And then as we head into Christmas Day, 65 degrees, mostly sunny skies for your Christmas. And then as we move throughout the rest of the week, we start to see temperatures in the 70s. So if you like to stay updated on the